And I'm going to start off with just a little bit of introduction about greenhouse gases and why we are concerned about them in the livestock industry, and then I'll turn it over to Baitong to talk about some of his research first. So just as a background, according to the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, 9% of all U.S. greenhouse gas emissions are from agriculture. There are other sources that attribute more, such as transportation, electricity, but 9% is something that we need to be concerned about. And enteric methane emissions from ruminant animals account for 30% of that 9% slice of the pie there. And then manure management contributes another 14% to the total greenhouse gas emissions from the agriculture sector. And those emissions are primarily methane and nitrous oxide. Since the 1990s, greenhouse gas emissions from agriculture has increased 8.8%. So we do need to be looking at this issue, and that's why it's being addressed. If we look at the different gases that compose the greenhouse gases, carbon dioxide is by far has the greatest quantity. It has 76% of the total greenhouse gas emissions are carbon dioxide. Another 16% come from methane, but methane does have a higher global warming potential, about 23 times that of carbon dioxide. And then finally, nitrous oxide accounts for about 6%, only 6%, but it does have a very high global warming potential. That's 296 times the global warming potential of carbon dioxide. And so that's why we are kind of focused on these three primary gases. And if you look at a livestock production system, there are nutrients that are brought in as the feed and also come in as the animal that comes into livestock production system. And some nutrients leave the system with the animal when they're marketed. But a lot of, in order to produce the ultimate product of meat, there are several nutrients that are left on the surface of the feedlot or the livestock production system. So some of these are carbon that are released in various forms. They may be released directly from the animal. In the case of ruminant animals, there's direct emissions from the animal as CO2 and methane. Nutrients that are not absorbed by the animal or digested are excreted in the form of nitrogen, phosphorus, carbon, sulfur, and many others. And bacteria can digest the manure and produce additional methane or carbon dioxide. They can also break it down into some of these sulfur products like total reduced sulfurs or hydrogen sulfide. And then nitrogen, it can be transformed and volatilized into the air as ammonia, or it can go into the soil, might be leached into the groundwater, or it can undergo additional transformations and be released as nitrogen gas or also as nitrous oxide. So there's also concerns about odor and dust and runoff that can come from livestock production systems. And ultimately, some nutrients are returned to the soil when we use land application of the manure. And the crops that are grown on this soil then, of course, come back to the system as feed. However, there's a lot of points in this system that you can see where we are losing nutrients to the air. And we are particularly concerned about these gaseous losses here that come from the manure digestion. So how can producers reduce their greenhouse gas emissions? Well, they can target three primary areas. There's potential to reduce greenhouse gas emissions from all three of these areas, and they should all be considered as part of a comprehensive approach to reducing greenhouse gas emissions from an operation. Greenhouse gases can be reduced through the management of land and crops. For example, producers can use plant tissue testing or soil testing as a tool to better match fertilizer application with crop nutrient needs. They could use slow-release fertilizers or nitrification inhibitors, or maybe make changes to application timing to better match crop nutrient uptake and reduce greenhouse gas emissions from the fields. If we look at improvements in feed efficiency through the diet or housing, there's some other management strategies that producers can use to lower greenhouse gas emissions through livestock management. And then finally, manure management. And one example, if we're talking about a way to manage greenhouse gas through manure management, would be through methane or anaerobic digestion. Because this captures methane and can convert it for electricity, which would reduce greenhouse gas emissions directly by using methane that would have been emitted into the atmosphere. But that could also replace CO2 emissions that may be generated from fossil fuel-based electricity. So that's just one example. But today we're going to share with you some research that was conducted at Iowa State University and at the USDA. And it's going to focus mainly on these last two points, the livestock management and the manure management.